When Dean Ambrose first came to WWE, you, I, and everybody in that locker room saw the promise. He had toughness in the ring. He had this unorthodox charisma. He was going to be the next Roddy Piper. He was going to be the breakout star of the Shield. But boy, were we all wrong. See, we got wacky Dean Ambrose, someone who would rather tell a joke than accept the real truth. And the real truth is Dean Ambrose can't handle success.
You know, look, Miz, I heard everything you said back there and everything you said about me. You know what? It's all true. You are exactly right about everything. I mean, you really got me all figured out. But since you know me so well, you would know that maybe I don't care that you're standing behind two bodyguards right now. I might come down in that ring and whoop your ass anyway. And since you know me so well, you would know that I'm probably gonna want my rematch for the Intercontinental Championship. And since, like you said, I love jokes so much, you know what I think would be hilarious? If we had that rematch tonight, right here, right now.
I'm just one man, but I'm the one man.
Now this is interesting.
I don't mean to be rude or disrespectful at all, but the last man to beat Miz in that ring wasn't Dean Ambrose. It was Heath Slater. And I mean, I've never even had a shot at the Intercontinental title, not even an opportunity. I mean, hell, I haven't had a shot or opportunity at any single title in the WWE. And I've been here for 8 years. Right? I've got a family, I've got kids, and I'm sick and tired of going home each week and looking at them and saying, you know what, don't worry about anything. Daddy's got this. You know what? Don't worry. Daddy's gonna make everything okay. But in reality, Daddy doesn't have this. Daddy don't know if he's gonna make everything okay. But what it boils down to is that I need this opportunity, I want this opportunity, and I have earned this opportunity.
Understand that you will get your rematch when I say you get your rematch. And Heath, touching story, amazing. I bet everybody in West Virginia is so exciting, adjusting their rabbit ears on their black and white TV, hoping that they'll see an IC title match, but it's not going to happen.
Hold on a second, Miz. You don't get to say when and where you compete. I do.
Are you kidding me right now? Why don't you go over to Corey Graves and talk about your personal problems and stay out of my business?
I'd watch your mouth if I were you.
Or what? I'm your rating spike. I'm your big box office draw here in the WWE. But I'll tell you what, I'll do you this favor, Kurt. I'll defend my title at the Great Balls of Fire pay-per-view this Sunday. All you have to do is tell me who I'm going to face, Heath Slater or Dean Ambrose.
How about both? Listen here, Miz. Dean Ambrose will get his rematch for the Intercontinental Championship this Sunday at Great Balls of Fire. But you're gonna put that title on the line tonight against Heath Slater. And that starts right now. Oh, it's true. It's damn true.
Oh, Heath Slater, he's got kids, and he's got an Intercontinental.